A telephone company produces and sells two kinds of telephones, desk and cellular phones. Each type of phone is assembled and painted by the company. The objective is to maximize profit, and the company has to produce at least 100 of each type of phone. There are limits in terms of the company's production capacity. The company has to calculate the optimal number of each type of phone to produce, while not exceeding the capacity of the plant. The production data is shown in the table. A desk phone's processing time is 12 minutes on the assembly machine and 30 minutes on the painting machine. A cellular phone's processing time is 24 minutes on the assembly machine and 24 minutes on the painting machine. The assembly machine is available for only 400 hours and the painting machine is available for only 490 hours. Desk phones return a profit of $12 per unit and cellular phones return a profit of $20 per unit. A possible descriptive model of this telephone production problem is as follows. The decision variables are the number of desk phones and cellular phones to be produced. The objective is to maximize profit. The constraints are that the desk production and the cell production must be greater than or equal to 100. The assembly time for the desk production plus the assembly time for the cell production must not exceed 400 hours. The assembly time for the desk production plus the assembly time for the cell production must not exceed 490 hours. Here is the mathematical formulation of the telephone production problem. The model starts with the objective, namely to maximize the profit. Next, follow the production limit constraints and the constraints on the available assembly and painting time. The formulation ends with the variable domains, namely that the variable values must come from a set of real numbers. This problem is a typical example of an LP model. Real-world models will typically involve many more variables and constraints, or even additional objectives.